Bayoumi's The Funeral of Lee of Sir Lee Stack is notable for its signaling a diplomatic circumspection to Bayoumi's nationalist politics. Bayoumi had served in the Egyptian military in Palestine, but was recalled when he protested British soldiers' refusal to salute him. Indeed, his diary is replete with condemnations of British rule. He nevertheless elected to document in Cairo the funeral commemorating Sardar General Lee Stack, Governor General of the Sudan, assassinated by Egyptian nationalists. The row that occasioned the assassination was grave and occurred within an already strained relationship between the newly independent state and an occupier that had not relinquished controls over such matters as foreign affairs, protection of the Suez Canal, and the European Department in the Ministry of Interior. Also notable is that the funeral of Sir Lee Stack is one of two Bayoumi news films that showcase the news film's main point of appeal, to capture a glimpse of a world-class personality. In this case, Prime Minister Saad Zavloul walking in procession. In 1930, Bayoumi made a Weft committee celebration in Alexandria on the occasion of welcoming and bidding farewell to the official negotiating delegation headed by Al-Nahas Pasha. Al-Weft had been by far the most powerful political party in Egypt since independence. Its first leader, Prime Minister Saad Zavloul, had resigned in 1924 under pressure from British authorities following the assassination of Lee Stack. Zavloul was succeeded by Mustafa Al-Nahas, who had been exiled with Zavloul in the Seychelles and subsequently served as minister in his cabinet. This film captures images of the official farewell to Nahas and of Nahas himself, the other dignitary that Bayoumi managed to capture cinematographically during his career, though far more intimately than the depiction of Zavloul earlier. Al-Nahas would later resign because of his negotiating team's inability to agree to terms of a treaty of independence with their counterpart representing the government of British Prime Minister Ramsay MacDonald.